I'm a dancer. I can find. I can make my way without touching any chords. And I've seen enough zombie movies to know that it can't touch the viney thing. How are you all? It's so good to see you all here. Thank you for coming out this evening. My cell phone script, hashtag 2021. My name is Chris Walker. I'm the director of the Division of the Arts. I have the distinct pleasure of introducing this evening. This has been a phenomenal residency, y'all. Arun Luthra has been here since what feels like forever, but it's only a semester. But when you've made so many connections into so many communities, it kind of feel like forever. Feel like he's here before and will be here after. So thank you for that deeply impactful work. So please give me a moment to just say a few words about the folks who made that happen and some of what that work was. I promise, less than 5 minutes, I've timed it. So we're talking about Arun Luthra, saxophonist, composer, and konnakol artist. Arun Luthra is an American musician of Indian heritage who fuses modern post-bop black American music with elements of Indian classical music, especially konnakol, a South Indian classical music vocal percussion. He connects a wide range of modern and classical music influences to create a vibrant new sound and a style. We are so very grateful for the work that Arun has done here in Madison. I want to extend a big thank you to Jolene and the Arts Lit Lab team. Arun Luthra's first residency event began here on June 15th as part of the Madison Jazz Festival, organized by Arts Lit Lab. And we now close out the public performances, so to speak, with tonight's performance. So thanks for this partnership. Arun's residency has been widely impactful, connecting with and touching many diverse communities. Luthra's konnakol jazz project performance in September was the first live show at the Wisconsin Union Theater. Rohan Krishnamurthy was a part of that performance. We welcome you back to Madison. Thank you for being here. Arun has had a very busy semester working with and performing with lead faculty, Johannes Wallman. Give it up for Johannes Wallman. Along with many UW-Madison musicians, faculty, students, including the Contemporary Jazz Ensemble, since this summer there have been 13 public performances, including workshops with our partners and supporters, already mentioned Arts Lit Lab, Center for South Asian Studies, Wisconsin Science Festival, or host department, of course, the Mead Witter School of Music. Special shout out to Susan Cook, the department chair. Special shout out to the faculty, staff, and students of the School of Music. We also want to thank the Department of Anthropology, Office of Multicultural Arts Initiatives, and the studio and Tandem Press for their support. You see the diversity of areas and folks that this man has connected with. Arun has been invited to perform around the region, including we're working with students in many other classes. So generous. And tonight's event, you'll feel that generosity and will feature performances from students in both the classes he taught this semester. The Universal Language of Rhythm, Explorations through Konnakol and Black American Music, and the Contemporary Jazz Ensemble. Y'all, welcome Arun Luthra.
Thank you so much, Chris. Thank you to all of you for being here. It's hard to find the words. This semester has been an incredible, the phrase I came up with is a joyous time of discovery. It's been a real honor to be here. I want to echo a lot of what Chris said about my heartfelt gratitude to all the folks who made this residency possible. Johannes has been mentioned, Jolene here at Arts Lit Lab, Heather Owens, who's been incredible director of the residency program, and so many other folks, and all the musicians that who've played my music with me, and these incredible students, it's funny. I just feel really emotional. You know that wow, this is a special night, and I'm very excited. And so also thank you to all of you for being here. So I want to get started right away. We had a lot of amazing work to get through. We'll start the program with three students' projects. Ryan Keek, Resonance, Abigail Arkley, Metamorph, and Finn with a project called Fluidity. And as I said, we have a lot of work to get through, so let's get right to it. Ryan, this project is up. Luke on the projector.
Thank you. Ta ga ta ki ta ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na tom ta ga ti mi ta ki ta ta ga ta tom ta ta ga ta ki ta ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na tom ta ga ti mi ta ki ta ta ga ta dom ta ga ta ga ki ta ga ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na dom ta ga ti mi ki ta ga ta ga ta 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 ki ta ga ta ta ki ta ta ga ti na dom ta ta ga na dom ta ga ti mi ta ta ki ta dom ga ta 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 ga ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na dom ga ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na dom ta ga ti mi ta ki ta ta ga ta ki ta ta ti ta ga dom ta ta ga ti ta ga ti mi ta ta ti ki na dom ta ga ti mi ta ta ki ta ki ta ga ta ta ti dom ta ga ta ga ta ki ta ta ga ti mi ta ti ta na dom ga ta ga ti da ta ga ti mi ta ga ti ki na dom ta ki ta ga ki ta dom ga ta mi ta ga ti ki na dom ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na dom ga ta ga ti dom ta ga ta ga dom ki ta ta ga ti ma ki ta ti ki ga ti mi ta ta ti mi na ta ki ta ga ti ga ta ki ta ta dom ga ta 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 ga ta ki ta mi ta ga ti mi na ta ti ki ga dom mi ta ga ki ta ta ga ta 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 ga ta ta ga ta ta ki ta ki ta ga ti ga ti ta ti ki na dom na ta ga ti ga ti ta ki ta ki ta ga ta ga ta dom ta ta ga ta ki ta ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na dom ta ki ta ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na dom fluidity ta ga ti mi ta ti ki na dom ta ki ta fluidity ta ti ki na dom ta ki ta ta ga ti mi tom. Thank you.
So I was so excited, I was, you know, I flew through my opening remarks very quickly, but I wanted to make a couple of points. One is this journey of exploration that we've been, engaged in this semester has really focused on the idea that rhythm as a phenomenon is something which we can experience in almost every aspect of the universe as we experience it. So that could be the frequencies of different light waves and that make colors, or it could be our heartbeats, or it could be the orbits of planets, or it could be, in quantum mechanics, particle wave duality and the frequencies of those particles that become waves, or it could be the changings of the seasons. Just rhythm is everywhere. The notion of pitch and the frequency of musical notes, those are rhythms too. So when you see, for example, all these different colors and the way the different geometries are expressed through rhythmic phrases, you know, this is really, what we've been exploring this semester. And, it's just so amazing to me to see this work and really see how we've looked at these phenomena and looked at rhythm and then taken it all these different directions in ways that I never could have imagined. Also, just to point out, everyone's project is described in the program. So, to save time, please check out what it says in the program so we can flow the show from one person to the next. And next up, excuse me for a second here, is Lukas Hrovatstadter, an untitled work. Come on down.
You can talk amongst yourselves for one sec. That'll help. Taka taka demi taki ta taki ta taka demi taka taka demi taki ta taki ta taka demi. Thank you.
Music is the truth, tap and create beyond aesthetic. Music transfusion between us, it's a foregone conclusion. Think about the way that people talk. Resonance, we feel it when we walk. Think vibration, eloquence of genesis, communicating waves. Relevance of consciousness awaits. Ubiquitous intelligence, the claim. One synchronicity, explicitly the goal. One dime, we exist upon a spectrum, we're the same. Free the duality, reality, instead of aligned, think circle in time. Always oscillating motion, frequency, lyrical, spherical, spawning human decency. Connect the mind, body, rhythm, pitch beyond time. Spiritual miracle, transcend, form your consequence. Oh, I,
that's what I'm talking about. Thank you. So in keeping, you know, with that vein of the notion of these incredible cultural fusions, which we've all thought of, and these incredible connections that rhythm can, you know, inspire in our minds, please welcome Nick Moran and Jimena Morales.
That was amazing, by the way. That was great. know, with the title of this course being Konnakol and the Scope of Black American Music, we wanted to do a little experiment with our project. One of the biggest takeaways we had in this course was Konnakol as a really important musical tool for learning rhythms, learning complex rhythms, and internalizing those rhythms. And so our experiment with you today is we're going to teach you a style of Black American music by using Konnakol. Both Jimena and myself and our special guest Richard Hildner are of Peruvian descent. And there's some wonderful music that comes out of Peru, and especially the coastal Peru. We have a lot of Afro-Peruvian rhythms. So we're going to do three styles with you, and we're going to need some participation from our audience to help us out. So a lot of the konnakol that you've been hearing, now is your chance to try it with us. So our first style is a waltz. And you'll notice that waltz sounds a lot like waltz. And it's actually the Peruvian music is a fusion of European, African, and indigenous elements. And so the Viennese waltz is a European element. And then we have our instrument here, the cajon, which is an African instrument, an instrument of African descent. And then the melodies that you'll hear when we get our rhythm going, you'll hear a lot of indigenous elements in that as well. So the waltz, if you want to help us, again, we're thinking in threes, right? One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. And let's start with the bottom one, if you can see that. Or you can turn off the lights if that's easier to see. But we're thinking one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Ta, ki, ta, 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 ta. Exactly. Keep that going. Now the claps. On top of that, does this half of the room want to do the ta-deems? Now, if this side of the room wants to do the other cajon chord, ta ka ta ki ta ta ka ta ki ta ta. Keep that going, we're gonna play this. Work. Now, we weren't sure how that was going to work, but you guys are doing a great job. So we're going to do a couple more, if that's all right. So another really popular style. I'm going to pass this off to Jimena to explain this one.
Hi, everyone. I'm Jimena. So for this next tune, we're going to be introducing the musical style festejo. Festejo translating in Spanish to festival, celebration. In Spanish, it's a musical genre. I'm just going to stick to what I wrote. It's a musical genre that I grew up listening to when I was younger. That is influenced by African rhythms and is native to Peru. It is one of the more popular Afro-Peruvian styles and one of the main cultural attributes to my upbringing. When I first thought to use what we had learned in class to transcribe the rhythms of festejo into konnakol, I felt very overwhelmed by the polyrhythm that you will soon get to hear and feel. Really, I have Nick to thank for helping us put this together, this project, by really breaking down these instruments into a transcribable level. Because of his deep understanding and knowledge of the instrumental patterns alone, I would not have been able to do this. In this case, which we will be reciting, is the pattern of the cajon, quijada, and cajita. So the cajon pattern, we have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, dom, ta ta ki ta, ta ka ta ki ta, dom, ta ta ki ta, ta ka ta ki ta, dom, ta ta ki ta, ka ta ki ta, dom, ta ta ki ta, ta ka ta. Now for the next one, keep that going. Ta ka ta ki ta, ta di ki na dom, 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 ta di ki na dom. So some people can start to do the tadikinato, tadikinato, taka takita, tadikinato, taka takita. Okay. Then this last one is kahita. Yes, yes, keep going. Taka takita to, ta takita, taka takita, tadikinato, 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 taka takita. Okay, for this last one it's ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta 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 ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta 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 ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta. Okay, keep that going. Good. Ta ta ki ta ta ka ta ki ta ta ka ta ki ta ta ka ta ki ta
ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta ki ta ta
So you guys are doing an amazing job. So we saved the most complicated rhythm that throws a lot of people for the last one. So we can do this. This is a rhythm in Lando. And again, this is all from coastal Peru. And this rhythm is, again, same kind of feel. But with this, we're thinking 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Tom, ka, tadi, kato, kato, tadi, kato. Oops, sorry, I did that wrong. Sorry. 3, 4.
Tom, ka. Tadim, katom, katom, tom, ka, tadim, katom, katom, tom, ka, tadim, katom, katom.
Then the bell part, takita, taka, tom, takita, taka, tom,
takita, taka, tom, takita, taka, tom, takita, taka, tom, takita, taka, tom, takita, taka, tom. Thank you.
Jimena Morales, Richard Hilden, Nick Rand. Thank you.
So as you heard from Chris, you know, the title of the course is Explorations Through Konnakol and Black American Music, and hopefully it's becoming very evident in these projects that these Afro-diasporic musics, which are the product of the horrors of colonialism and slavery, have become the musical lingua franca of the world. If you listen to pop music, any music all over the world, black music is at its center. And to hear how we can take these traditions, and we listen to konnakol and the rhythmic vernacular of that music, and we see how it can be blended with these Afro-diasporic traditions, to me is just an incredibly moving thing to hear. And it's just been so gratifying to see, you know, us as a group really discover these connections and create these sounds with these cultural blendings. Our next project is by Jacob Moratori, and you know, we spent quite a lot of time talking about issues of colonialism and social justice, racial justice, gender justice. And if you read the description of Jacob's project, you'll see that you know, he brings a really wonderful slant to the notion of, or he brings the material that we covered to an issue of gender justice. So please welcome Jacob.
So, if everybody can have a look up here at the manuscript that is shown there. That is a movement of one of the cello suites by Johann Sebastian Bach. And this is a copy of one of the oldest manuscripts we have. Bach, we don't have anything in Bach's handwriting. As cellists, that's kind of a bummer because, you know, it's kind of like a game of telephone because, you know, you copy it over and somebody makes a mistake and then someone copies the copy and then they make a mistake and someone copies. And this was written about 300 years ago. So the interesting thing about this manuscript is that it was written by, physically written by Anna Magdalena Bach, who was Bach's second wife. And I became fascinated with Anna Magdalena and her influence and her contribution to her husband's work that no one knows about. This manuscript is one of the only reasons that we as cellists have this music today. And Anna Magdalena Bach wrote it with her own hand in service to her husband, which was kind of the culture at the time. What was expected of women was, once you got married, you were in service to your husband, and you had children as often as possible, and then ultimately you probably died in childbirth, and that was just kind of what happened. I'd like to read to you an excerpt here describing the role of Anna Magdalena, because she was kind of like an assistant of sorts to J.S. Bach, and she copied out instrument parts for performances and things. This was copied out for a customer who wanted a copy of the cello suite. So this says, as a mother who became pregnant almost every year in the first 10 years of her marriage, as well as looking after her children, one can imagine how difficult it would have been for her to maintain her focus for long periods of time. This aspect should not be forgotten when discussing her role as copyist. And there are other historical records of Anna Magdalena having a horrible pregnancy complication, and they thought that she might not make it. That's actually where the title of my project, Frau Bach, comes from, because her family apparently referred to her as Frau Mama. As a term of endearment, this is unbelievable. She had 13 children of her own, and she also took care of the children from her husband's previous marriage. And she was also his assistant, basically. So I've been thinking about history, because I'm a classical cellist. I went to music school. I have an undergraduate degree in classical performance. I didn't learn any of that. I didn't learn about how women were treated in the period of time this music that I'm studying. I started to think about, well, what is history and who is writing it and why does that matter? So the people who have written the history, it seems like the textbooks, they've conveniently left out all of this horrible stuff, misogynistic treatment of women, and I think it's an important part of the history, because you can't really separate it, because the culture creates the art, and the culture of the time also includes this treatment of women. So that's one thing I was looking into, and as I was thinking about writing and writing things down and passing it to the next generation, which is what we do in European Eurocentric culture. We tend to think in the Western classical music world that is the correct way to do it. And any other culture that does not have a system of passing things down by writing must be less significant or less culturally rich. And that is absolutely not the case. For example, konnakol in the Carnatic tradition of India is, in undergrad, I was sort of taught that it was like, we spent a third of a semester on international non-Western music, and it was kind of like thrown in there with stuff from Africa and stuff from South America and Native American music, and then we moved on to the real music, right? So I didn't ever really get a sense of the whole scope of the Carnatic music tradition, which is absolutely as rich as Western classical music, and it's just, it's a shame that we don't teach it that way. So I've taken an excerpt of this Bach cello suite, and I have kind of transliterated it, at least rhythmically, into konnakol. And I'd like to recite a little bit of konnakol for you and then play that rhythm as it occurs in the cello suite. So I think I'll do this phrase by phrase here. Ta dim, ta dim, ta takadina ta dim, ta takadim, ta takadim, ta takadina takadim. Ta tam dim, ta tangu takita tam dim, ta tangu takita tam dim, ta dim takadina ta. Takadina takatam dim ta, takadina takatam dim ta, takadina takatam dim ta. Takakita kita, takakita kita, takakita kita tam. Tamkakita kita, dimtakakita kita, tamtakita kita, numtakita kita, jamkita kita, numtakita kita, kita 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 tam. So it's thank you. Now, one of the things that Arun said to us in class is that the goal is not to become a konnakol virtuoso by the end of the semester. And I'm finding myself wishing that I were more virtuosic in my konnakol, because this goes a lot faster than I'm able to say it. And my goal in moving forward is to continue working on konnakol sort of in parallel with playing the cello, to be able to demonstrate really this. And a short example of that would be this. Ta dim, ta dim, ta takadina ta dim, ta takadim, ta takadim, ta takadina takadim. So. So. That's where this is headed. Thank you.
Thank you, Jacob, and let's give it up for Frau Mama. Yeah. So our next project is by Mark Harrod and Ritvik Chowdhury. I'd just like to say that, you know, the theme of this project includes issues of oppressive violence and racial justice, and there are images here in the video which are disturbing. So I want to let you know that.
Second, Johan. We're just going to make a quick announcement and then do an introduction on this. We'll be sharing two books that can be passed throughout the crowd for the rest of the performance tonight. We'll introduce the books and then we'll pass them out. Please make sure they come back to the guy in all black, right? Make sure they come back to me. And secondly, if any of the classmates are going to perform with us, this is the time you might need to, I don't know, have some kind of light on the sheets that I gave you. I'll be kind of leading us through it. And did you want to say anything?
Yeah, so right before we start the project that we worked on, I just wanted to thank you, Professor Arun. I think everybody knows he's had a lot of interesting discussions during class, a lot of topics covering Black America, the current system, current things that are going on in society. Not to mention bringing konnakol here, as you saw, the first presentation was very unique, the second, and so on. Everybody's kind of used konnakol in a different way, so I hope you enjoy what we have in our message. Thank you, Mark, for working with me. Thank you, everybody, for being here.
So in July of 2020, my mom and I drove So we drove the 54 miles between Selma and Montgomery in Alabama, and it was the same route that John Lewis, Martin Luther King Jr., and so many others marched in 1965 to protest the voting rights discrimination in that county. And in Montgomery, Alabama, now there exists a monument called the National Memorial for Peace and Justice. And that's that book, that other thinner book right there, this guy. The words and images at the beginning of this video are from this book, and it's about that memorial. And before you hand that out, I just want to, can you open it to that page? So the images in the chorus of this video are also from this book and from that memorial. The large rusted metal boxes you'll see represent each county in the United States where a death was caused by a lynching. The National Memorial for Peace and Justice opened to the public in April of 2018 and is the nation's first memorial dedicated to the legacy of enslaved black people, people terrorized by lynching, African Americans humiliated by racial segregation and Jim Crow, and people of color burdened with contemporary presumptions of guilt and police violence.
The remaining pictures in this video are from this book, Let's Talk About It, which Mark will show up in a second. The photos in this book were taken of local artwork created after the killing of George Floyd. This publication serves to preserve this local Madison area artwork and records for the history, the raw emotions, and stories of those who have endured racism and bias their entire lives.
This video is set to the song Glory by John Legend, Common, and Chase Smith. Selma is the movie it was set written for, is an unforgettable story which chronicles the tumultuous three-month period leading up to that Alabama march in 1965.
Our final project is a blend of konnakol, and in this song, we'll bring you to attention to these publications and hopefully stimulate productive conversations afterwards and thoughts with the dreams of closing equity gaps created by long history of oppression in this country. Go ahead.
Yeah, now you can turn the lights down, Rohan.
One short note before we start, I think, from Mark, right?
It's just time to get this.
When you hear students singing along, it's pretty simple. It goes, taka di mi, and you'll kind of follow along. Feel free to jump in. If not, step back. Go ahead.
For the hanged and beaten, for the shot, drowned, and burned, for the tortured, tormented, and terrorized, for those abandoned by the rule of law. With hope, because hopelessness is the enemy of justice, with courage, because peace requires bravery, with persistence, because justice is a constant struggle, with faith, because we shall overcome.
Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapons. Yes, formed against, yes, glory is destined. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. One son died, the spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Selma is now, but every man, woman, and child. Even Jesus got his crown in front of a crowd. They march with the torch, we gon' run with it now. We never look back, we done gone hundreds of miles. From dark road to become a hero, to become a hero. Facing the league of justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal, a king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a ball ego. No one can win the war individually. It takes the wisdom of the elders and young people's energy. Welcome to the story we call the victory. The coming of the Lord, my eyes have seen the glory. One day,
please welcome Kirtana Srinivasan.
All right. I don't know how I can follow that. But on that same aspect of Black Lives Matter, protests, and everything, something that we learned during class was that rhythm isn't everything, right? From the way we walk, the way we talk, to like the universe's rotation, there's rhythm in everything. So this project was actually inspired by Trevor Noah. There was a video that I watched where he talked about the rhythm in protests, and the way he made it seem was, well, he made a joke out of it, like in a comedic sense. He was talking about how the march of white people are different from the march of black people, and the way he portrayed that was because of the rhythm, the changes in the rhythm, and how that kind of portrayed the message differently. So I thought that was really interesting, and I wanted to kind of look into that further. I completely recognize that a protest and march song, struggle songs, are so much more than the rhythm, but I also think that the rhythm kind of helps you move forward. It's the beating heart, it's what keeps you going. So that's what I looked at. So in this video, what I did was I looked at two different themes for protests. So I did racial themes and I did environmental themes. And I did find some differences. I'll go into that kind of now. So I looked at three of the chants that became really popular during last year's BLM protests. So there were three of them. The first one was, "We gon' be all right, we gon' be all right." So that was one of them. The second one was, "I'm black and I'm proud, I'm black and I'm proud." That was the other. And the last one was, "No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace." And the theme that I looked at for the environmental protest, the chant went like, if I remember, all the people in the world fighting for climate justice. That's kind of how it went. I swear they do a better job in the video. But so now when I was like looking at the rhythm, the rhythms for the racial chants, they were more punchy, like the words are said more punchy, and I realized that they started on kind of an upbeat. So if we consider this as the downbeat, it doesn't start there. And for instance, no justice, no peace, no justice, no peace. And then I'm black and I'm proud, I'm black and I'm proud. They don't start on the downbeat, which I think just kind of adds to the urgency of the message, I'd say. It kind of keeps you springy and alert. So yeah, these are some of the things that I noticed. But the other thing that I noticed that were common with all these protest songs were that they're kind of set to like a 4x4 beat structure. And I think that's because it's like the default that we go to. It's the kind of rhythm that we already internalize. And so it's really easy for people to follow, because the point of a protest is that we're trying to build community, we're trying to get people to join, to understand, to support, to listen. So I think, I just thought that was really interesting. So in this video that we'll play in just a second, it'll start with Trevor Noah talking about rhythm protests, and then two examples of his version of black people doing a protest versus white people doing it. And then I show other footage of the BLM protests and then environmental protests, and then the konnakol that I added to it was just something that was inspired to me by these rhythms that I kind of tried to deconstruct. But yeah, hope you enjoy.
You realize a march is all about rhythm, right? 10% of every march. You realize a march is all about rhythm, right? 10% of every march is the issue, 90% is the beat. When black people march, you need to encourage others to join. Along the way, you need to pick up stragglers. Just some people who get into the rhythm as you move past. Moving.
Zuma must go. Zuma must go. Zuma must go. Zuma must go.
Tarikidatom. Tarikidatom. Takatomta. Takatomta. Taka tarikidatom. Tarikidatom. Tato tarikida. Takatomta. Tangudu tarikida. Takatomta. Tongidu tarikida. Takatomta. Tatinginatom. 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 Ta. Tatarikidatom. Tatarikidatom.
Anush, Austin, and Noah.
All right, we got some instruments and stuff to set up, so just feel free to talk among yourselves for a few minutes. We'll be right out here. Stuff and some of our last topics. Ours is going to be a bit of a departure from that. We kind of wanted to approach some of the more aspects talking about the universality of rhythm in this course, and one major component of that was something that Arun mentioned earlier, actually, which was kind of the idea that there's a lot of rhythms in our life, like stuff like the seasons, which at first glance isn't really obvious to us, and it takes some of that contextualization in those small in-between moments to really make it obvious. So we kind of tried to do that. You'll hear, it'll sound kind of random at first, but we're going to really contextualize it in that way. And then we also kind of sought to apply a really traditional konnakol form, the trikalam, which is a composition performed twice, essentially, in two different subdivisions, and you'll hear that as well, imposed over a blues form. So this is 497 blues.
Thank you.
So our next group of students is Henry Ptasek, Aiden Steer, Maggie Cousin, and Luke Levitt. And their project actually is truly interdisciplinary in that it includes musical elements and also a visual arts element, which you can see here. And while they're getting set up, I just wanted to also point out that one of our students, Reina Mayer-Torres, she couldn't be here tonight, but her project can be seen. It's a visual arts piece, which is outside in the entrance, so please take a look at that. It's called Aperture, and it's an exploration of the inherent rhythm of architecture and everything built within. Here we go.
Sounds like a good time to do some explanation. But my name is Henry, and the first composition was written by myself, and the second one is written by Aiden, and the third one is written by Maggie. And I can explain this a little bit. This is something that I did based off of a reduction already, and I divided the board mathematically using like beats. And the largest section is the last section of the reduction RD, which is tarikiridum, 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 da. So it's really fast and really dense. And then the first section is more sparse, but it takes up more beat space. And the middle and the top one is sort of like a, you know, it's like a middle version of that.
Thank you.
All right, so the course was entitled The Universal Language of Rhythm, Explorations Through Konnakol and Black American Music. And konnakol was a central part of what we studied. And right now, all of us here in the course would like to come up here and perform for you some konnakol.
Thank you.
And a quick note, I would like you to please welcome our very special guest artist. He's a brilliant Carnatic percussionist who performed with my group at the Play Circle Theater at the Wisconsin Union Theater back in September 10th, the inaugural event of my residency. And he's back with us tonight, Rohan Krishnamurthy. All right. To get into the groove of this, it's an 8-beat cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, all right, everybody getting it? Okay, here we go. Here we go, everybody. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
Thank you. Give it up again, come on now. Yeah.
I have to say, for my money, nothing makes the hairs on the back of my neck stand up more than unison konnakol. Oh, I love it, sounds so good.
Well done, everybody.
So now we'd like to present to you, to conclude the evening, some of the music that the Contemporary Jazz Ensemble that I've been directing this semester has been playing. And these are compositions of mine which incorporate konnakol into the Black American music tradition. So just give us a second to change over, and we'll bring you a little bit more music with Rohan Krishnamurthy. Thank you.
start, I can tell you we'll be beginning our program with some konnakol and percussion exchange. And these are phrases which are known as farens in the konnakol tradition. And they're designed to be phrases which are in the vernacular and create a sense of forward momentum or even excitement. So there'll be some trading between some konnakol and Henry on the drum set and Rohan on the marungum. And then we'll segue into a piece of mine, which for those of you keeping score at home is a contrafact, which means a melody written over previous chord changes on a John Coltrane composition called Giant Steps, and that composition of mine is called Third Event. Then we'll follow that with a featured solo improvisation by Rohan, and then we'll see where we go from there.
Kita kita taka taka tara kita taka di kita kita taka taka tara kita taka dom kita kita taka taka tara kita taka da kita kita taka taka tara kita taka da dom kita taka taka tara kita taka talom dom kita taka taka tara kita taka taka dom dom taka taka tara kita taka da taka taka di na taka tara kita taka da.
Talk to me.
listening to Bennett LeClaire on the tenor saxophone, Michael Wolf on the guitar, Luke Levitt on the piano, Aiden Steer on the bass, Henry Ptasek on the drum set. And now we want to invite Rohan Krishnamurthy back on stage with us to perform an improvisation in Mishra Chapu. Okay, all right. We're going to send you off with a co-composition of mine and my konnakol teacher, Selvanesh Vianakram. He gave me these skeletons of rhythm, kind of scaffoldings, and he said, Arun, I want you to write some music based on this stuff. I said, cool, so I put them on my computer. Song number one, song number two, song number three, song number four. And I started working on song number two, and then eventually I came up with something, and Rohan actually is the one who pointed out to me, if you're in the Carnatic music world, you love wordplay. So since the file was called song number two, I call this song two, T-O-O. So here we go with song two. Tuck it, tuck it in a tongue, 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 tuck it, Thank you so much, everyone. Bennett LeClaire, Michael Wolf, Luke Levitt, Aiden Steer, Henrik Tasek, our very special guest, Rohan Krishnamurthy. So much love to all of these fantastic students. What an incredible night. Thank you, Chris Walker, Johannes, Heather, everyone, Jolynn, who made this night possible. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and good night.